Okay, so how the DWSIM compares with other simulators on the web? I could say that ICE is my main inspiration for the interface for the Windows and for how you set up your simulation, because it's the only simulator I had contact. I worked with ICE on my early years, and it was basically my inspiration for Windows and everything else. So let's take a look at some images. I don't have a license for ICE, I'm sorry, but I will show you how some details about it, how it inspired me. Well, here you can see that the interfaces looks the DWSIM interface, the process flow sheet diagram looks a lot like ICE's, and I also was inspired by these controls to zoom and adjust and align the objects. The concept of a material stream I've also got from ICE's, because there are some simulators that don't have a material stream, explicit material stream. So this is ICE, the newer versions. I didn't like them. I think they make ICE's much slower, and I prefer the older versions. You can see that it looks a lot like the DWSIM. The reaction subsystem, I was inspired by ICE's on developing the type of the reactors, the conversion, the kinetic, the Gibbs and equilibrium reactors. I was inspired by ICE's on making them. Okay, so basically, I've used ICE's as an inspiration for the interface, for some features, and for how you set up your simulation by first defining the compounds and then defining the models, then setting up other things like the system of units, Aspen Plus. I don't know Aspen Plus, I never had to use it. I've only opened Aspen Plus a few times for curiosity, but I didn't like it very much because I think that the interface is too confusing. And okay, and Coco Simulator, it is for my friend Jasper, which is the developer of Coco. I like it a lot. So let's open Coco a little bit, but I can show you some things. This is my opinion, okay, guys? It's my own opinion. It's not. I think that Coco is. Some people use it for learning at universities, but the main objective of Coco is for people to test the KPOpen components that they create. It is not meant to be taken as a full process simulator, because you see that it only supports vapor liquid equilibrium. It's pretty limited on this aspect. Okay, so you can see that the DWSIM is already available, but let's use the Coco's own thermodynamic server, which is TIA-T. And you can see that's quite different from the DWSIM. You had to choose a proper package which already has a predefined list of compounds. This one has methane and ethane, and it is pretty closed. You can't change it or it now, but can change it later. But it's, with this selection, you've already configured your simulation. Okay. If you click on edit, you see that it has methane and ethane, and it already has the equilibrium selection made. It only supports vapor liquid equilibrium, as I've told you before. And the property calculations, you can select the model for each property individually. Quite different from the DWSIM. I wasn't inspired by this way yourself setting up things. I find it a little confusing for the user. But you have everything set up here, and you can already add a material stream, for example. I don't like the newer versions because I use it to do a double click to edit, and now it goes to rename the stream on a double click. I don't like that. Change the name, and you have to do a right click and click on edit view streams. Now you can change the flow of the component to something, define the pressure and the temperature, and it will calculate the properties of the streams. So you can see that it is quite different from DWSIM. I use it Coco a lot to test my KP Open interface, but I didn't get anything else from it to make the DWSIM. I use it only to test my interface and my models regarding the KP Open interfaces. Okay. Okay, what are the DWSIM main strengths? This is my own opinion again, guys. You may list something else on later after you finish this course on the feedback section, but for now this is only my opinion. Well, I think that the availability of the DWSIM is a big strength because it is available for everyone. Basically, if you have Windows, if you have Linux, if you have a Mac, if you have an Android device or an iPhone or an iPad, you can get the DWSIM to run on it. Also, the user interface. Some users say that it is very easy to work with it, and they're very user friendly, and they usually tell me that it is very beautiful, and I always like to make things easier for the user. Sometimes I fail, sometimes I succeed, but I always try to make everything easier for the user on each version I make. Also, the models that I'm seeing today has a lot of thermodynamic models and unit operations. I've been adding new models since the early days. I've stopped a little because I was focused on making it work on Mac and Linux and on the Python interfaces, but this was something that I was always preoccupied. And I was always worried to make the DWSIM have a basic set of unit operations and thermodynamic models. Also, the support. I've received a lot of emails during the day, and I've always looked to answer them right away because I've always with my phone, and I've always answered the emails as soon as I get them. I like to help people, as you may see. And there is also the bug fixing and new release. I'm always working on new versions. I'm always working on fixing the existing bugs. Most bugs I correct after the users tell me about them. If it is something very critical, I try to fix it right away. If it is something that can wait a little bit, I wait a few days to fix them. I do more tests before releasing an updated version, but I've always tried to correct the bugs as soon as possible. And for the weaknesses, you agree with me that the documentation is very poor, because if I had to make a choice between developing new features and writing the documentation, I will always choose to develop new features. I'm sorry, but this is the truth. Okay, guys. But I know that I should write a few more tutorials and write more documentation, and this own course is a tentative to fill that gap. Okay, you will see that there will be a lot of more courses regarding the DWSIM, and I hope that they fill the gap that is missing in the DWSIM documentation. Okay, there is also the issue of math instability, because I have to use, this is related to the last item which is the free tools only. I cannot use anything that is paid or anything that doesn't comply with the GPL license, so I have to stick with free tools and free numerical components, and sometimes they don't work very well. Sometimes they don't work at all, as you can see from some calculations from the rigorous columns. I'm sure that you already got some errors, already faced some errors with the DWSIM at some point, and this is not my fault. Of course, I have a lot to learn, but sometimes I have no choice. I know that HiSys and Aspen Plus have access to a lot of more professional tools. When they find something that is good, they just buy it, basically. I don't have that option. I have to work with what we already have on the internet, but I'm sure that we are on the right path. I feel that on each new version we are making the WC more stable and more reliable. But this is still something that we will always, this is still something that we will always need some attention, and we'll need to improve with time. Okay?